The first few days of school are still going to have some hallmarks for a successful teacher. And that is that your script is ready. Okay. Before the school year starts. And when I say script, I mean that you know what's going to happen in that first day of school. Within that class period, you've got it pretty well lined out. You do not want the first impression for, especially if you're new students, to be you standing up in front of your class, twiddling your thumbs, wondering what's going to come next, and visibly looking like you're confused. And this might seem super obvious, but I see this all the time from young teachers, where it's, I'm going to wait until I get up in front of the students to come up with what I'm going to say. Now, I will say at the year 20, that takes a lot less work than it does at year 5, because you start to have a routine and you start to have your own processes, but that's important. So whether you are the type of person who likes to write out notes or jot down a bullet point sketch, or whatever it is, like there's lots of ways that could look, you know, for you millennials, it could be a digital something, and that's fine. But as long as you have a plan, the first day of school should also establish consistency while awakening possibility. What I mean by that is that there again does need to be some structure and a routine. In other words, will they experience a sample of your class, a sample during that time of what your class is going to be like? The next one, the goal is making what are we going to do today go away as soon as possible. And that is something I'm very proud of in my classroom. Kids just don't ask. Like they don't ask because they know we're going to sing because we sing every day. And because the class period is structured essentially the same way every day, there's tons of variety that happens within that structure and tons of surprises and all that kind of stuff. But it happens within a structure that they can predict. And we're going to talk about that later. But so they just stop asking what are we going to do today in that? And I don't mean in that really awesome, like curious, wanting to learn kind of way, but you know what way I'm talking about, that annoying, like, what are we going to do today? As if like there isn't a plan, and as if they're trying to get out of something, right? And that's a different way. And so I've essentially eliminated that in my classroom environment, which is extremely important. Okay, so we did the what stage are you already. I'm going to skip that. Okay, so before we even get to the first days of school, this is our T-1 week. Okay, so just a way to think about this, the school year is not even started yet. Is your syllabus and your handbook ready? It seems obvious, but you'd be surprised. Have you already talked about, especially you younger teachers, have you already talked about your syllabus with your administrators? And I don't mean just doing whatever bare minimum submission of your syllabus was required to put it into a Google Drive that your principal will never look at. I don't mean that. I mean, have you gone over your grading policies with your administrator to get their rubber stamp? Because here's the thing, for music teachers, we can pretty much assume that our administrators don't understand how we're grading, and they don't understand in what way an A will be earned, so to speak, in our class. And there will be those moments later on where some kid gets a B or some kid gets a C in a music class, and the common cultural attitude is how could a kid get a B in a music class? Like, or did they try to kill someone that day? Like what is going on here? And they won't understand. But if you've had that conversation prior, then at the very least you can show that email that says, oh, so actually I showed you all of my rubrics. I showed you all these things. These are what was communicated to the parents. You okayed this. And then it's a whole lot harder for that administrator to not give you that support. And that's really important. And so I think a lot of young teachers skip that because they just assume they will have that support. And a lot of times it does not work that way. We have to scaffold or run triage ahead of time a lot of times to get that support. Rubrics, they're all in your handbook, in your syllabus before the school year even starts. That's really, really important. It's very hard to change any of this stuff after the fact. In fact, in the Harry Wong book, The First Days of School, that's kind of the core tenet throughout the entire book, which is that if these things are not ready on the first day of school, it's too late. You might as well wait till next year, because it is very difficult with young people and with their parents and administrators to come back after the fact and say, well, what I meant was this is what I actually expect 3 weeks later. It just doesn't work. It would be lovely if it did, if you could, if a young teacher could step up in front of class and say, you know what, guys, I really screwed up the first 3 weeks of school and I was not organized, but could we just start fresh? They could say like, yeah, sure, Mrs. So-and-so or whatever, but it just isn't going to work. They will be already used to what they've been allowed to do and what they've been asked to do so far. Communications. That just means, do you already have a way to quickly get out emails to all of your rosters and to their parents? Do you have whatever your school's electronic interface is? We have Schoology, Google Classroom, whatever it is that you have. Have you worked all of that stuff out? And have you clicked through it a whole bunch of times to make sure you didn't do something stupid when you set it up? Because these things will come back to bite you later. And then since we're choir teachers, music teachers, do you have your repertoire planned out? And I want to talk a little bit about that before I move on, because repertoire is tricky. I've got done entire podcast series on this kind of thing because it's so tricky, but it depends. So I'm going to think about mostly for this class tonight, what are we thinking about for our repertoire choices before the school year starts with kids we've never met? Okay. Because for my advanced choir, that's easy because I've known those kids for 3 years. I know what we can do next year already. But with my freshmen coming in, no idea. I've got no idea what they're capable of. That's different every year. And so what I try to think about are getting one piece for a choir. I want one piece ready on the first day of school. That's it. I don't want to go two or three because I want to see what they're capable of, but I also don't want to have nothing in my hand. I want to have some piece of music that they can pass out, and it needs to look like real choir music. It needs to be an actual printed something that I can pass out to them to establish that this is a performance class. We are going to be rehearsing repertoire and we're going to be working on this from today all the way to the end of the school year. This is our process, because again, that first day of school is about establishing a process.